I need to do something big, something really, really big. And it's not necessarily going to be a programmatic change. There's a little bit of one, but there's a big change that's going to happen under the hood of my head that is far more important. And this is the one thing that's going to help me be successful from now at 4 weeks out up until show day. Hello, everybody, and welcome to the 4 week out update. Here we go. I'm Darren Starr. Thank you for joining me once again. We are 4 weeks out from the Battle at the River, Chattanooga, Tennessee, June 8th, 2024. It feels like it's been a long time, actually. Last week's update was from the West Coast. It was not in the studio here, a little haphazard on the phone, uploaded very quickly. Feel like I'm out of the routine. I'm back in the routine now. I'm recording this on Sunday, on Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day to all you out there. I've been back here since, well, early Wednesday. I got in around 2 a.m. Wednesday morning, operating on very little sleep. So it's been a little bit of a rough week here getting reacclimated. It was a little bit trickier still in Oregon, but let's go ahead and dive in here and see where things are at this point, now being today, 27 days out. First thing to cover here are some changes that have been implemented recently. A lot of this is going to just be like reversing some negative adaptations that happened during travel. When I was in Oregon, my sleep was terrible. My diet was a little off. It wasn't too bad. It's just when you get used to being perfect every day and then you're not perfect for a little bit, it feels like you've just completely lost the plot and everything's falling apart. So that kind of sucks. It wasn't too bad though. In Oregon, I was getting maybe 3 or 4 hours of sleep a night. It wasn't much. I was still sick. I'm still not 100%, but I was definitely hurting a lot more there. Just, you know, really bad sore throat still the whole time, pretty congested the whole time as well. Not a lot of fun. And so that had an impact on training. I would say most of my workouts were in the 6 to 7 out of 10 range as far as quality is concerned. I missed some cardio minutes really because I was too damn tired to do it. And also, you know, I was there ostensibly to visit family, and I'm sitting there, I'm doing my workouts, I'm doing all this stuff, I'm grinding away on cardio. I'm like, I gotta go see people. And so I did pull some sessions short a little bit just because, first of all, I was not going hard enough to really make it worthwhile, and I had other places to be. I am not afraid to pull some punches here and there when I need to. There just has to be a really good reason for it, and that I felt was a pretty good reason. The diet's back on track. You know, I had a meal prep service when I was out there. Everything has been back on point since returning back to Tennessee, however. So today is Sunday. Yesterday, Saturday, I did a high day, and this was kind of to simulate a little bit of pre-show loading, and then I did some posing this morning, and we'll see that too. Had some breakthroughs this week since coming back. I was really kind of surprised by how things were looking and how things were feeling, so took the opportunity to take that high day kind of like as a end of peak week test run at 4 weeks out just to see how things worked. Oregon, mostly on point. Had a little bit extra one day, extra meal another day. Sleep sucked. Training was iffy. It was not my best effort, but it was pretty good. It was okay. I kept mostly strong there, just not perfect. And like I said, when you get used to being perfect and then you're not, it feels like you've lost a lot, but really, like, it's still fine. How things feel. So at this point, I do feel like I'm mostly recovered from the Oregon trip. Sleep has caught up. I've been taking some naps in the afternoon pretty regularly just to try and catch up a little bit more, sleeping in a little bit more as well, which is unusual for me, but I just felt like I needed to. I'm still kind of dragging ass a little bit. My energy is down. Training is still good. I can still get up for a lift on the days when I need to. Outside of that, there's not a whole lot left in the tank. Taz is getting slower and slower walks. they're still happening. Cardio, it's getting, you know, I have these metrics that are set, like, you know, calories per minute burned on the machine according to the display. It's getting harder and harder to hit those old metrics just because I have to push a little bit harder. I'm like, oh, this was easier before. It's a lot harder now. So it feels like performance is kind of tailing off a little bit there. Appetite, this is where it's really weird. Like, my appetite is fine. I'm not typically hungry day to day. I cannot stop thinking about food, however. It's like once a meal comes, and it's like, okay, cool, I ate that. I'm really not hungry, but I can't stop eating. Like, I do, but I really don't want to. It's very strange phenomenon. And it's just because prep has been going on for a long time, and frankly, my brain is just sick of it at this point. So it's ready for it to be done. So if there was a show next week, I would totally do it. I would totally do it at this point. Just like, let's get it over with. Let's get it done and gone. Sleep has been better overall. I'm just really tired for the most part. But you know, overall, I'd say for being 4 weeks out, 27 days out, I feel about like I should probably. All right, how things look. Here's the video. Check it out. This is from Fasted this morning. Woke up a little late. I was in a little bit of a hurry, actually, because we'll see at the end of this video, if you stick around till the very end, I did some posing at the gym. So this is just cold in the morning, fasted, and it looks okay. Like, I'm fine with this. It's okay. I'm not ready by any stretch of the imagination. So when I say if there was a show next weekend, I would do it, no, I wouldn't. Like, I need to be another 3 weeks leaner than this for sure, if not another five or six, realistically. A couple people are telling me like, hey, you look pretty lean right now. You're good to go. I wouldn't worry about losing too much more. I just don't buy that at all. Like, no, there's still plenty on there that can come away. So I'm not trying to get too complacent with things. I am trying to take a slightly different approach going forward, which we'll talk about in a little bit here. So I think it looks pretty good, honestly. I'm happy with this. And then what I did is I went to the gym this morning on a day off, and I just did a quick 15-minute pump-up routine. And then I went into the posing room, set up the cameras, and did a multi-camera posing session. So we'll see an edit of that at the end of this video so you can see how things look with a little bit of a pump from a few different angles also. So I feel pretty good about this. Again, not quite ready, but I do feel pretty good about it. So, one thing that we're going to do here shortly as well is we're actually going to register for the show today. So we're going to do that on this video here. I'm going to renew my NPC card, register for the show. So if you haven't registered for a show before, I'll take you through that process so you can see what it's like. And we'll spend some money together. So if anybody wants to chime in with their credit card, let me know. So posing again, looks pretty good. I don't have any major complaints about this. I'll offer some more narration on the video at the end. Okay, the numbers. Here's the tracker for the week. Check it out here. So I put an extra column in here, which are the, I started reporting daily macros here. I started doing that on the 8th. You can see, if we go back to Oregon, the 4th and the 5th, this would have been Saturday and Sunday of last week. Had some extra carbs on the 4th. They're untracked. It was about 30 to 40 grams. And then on the 5th, there was a family meal out. We went to Olive Garden of all places. And I just ended up just saying, whatever, had an extra meal. Don't know what happened as far as the scale. I didn't have a scale with me on that trip. So it was just kind of flying blind. You can see where the workout quality was there. I did have one that was back in arms. It was pretty good. You can see some cardio minutes got left behind here. The morning walks were a little bit longer, but I was out there like in the cold, in the rain, just walking through the neighborhood that I was staying in. It was not very fun. It was like 40 degrees in the morning getting rained on. Not fun. Not fun. So since then, starting the 8th, you can see where the macros have been. And some of these, like, typically my numbers are the same every single day. There's some variation here simply because I used a meal prep company in Oregon, had a few extra meals, brought those back with me. So I've been implementing those. They're all gone now. And so I think the 10th is the first day where it was like, hey, this is back on my normal meal prep. This is what the numbers are supposed to look like. And then yesterday, the 11th, you can see high carb day. So I had an extra 50-ish grams of protein, an extra 270-ish grams of carbs, an extra 115 or so grams of fat. So just took a high day, just like, hey, let's eat, let's do it, let's fill up, let's get some posing done this morning, filled out and see what that looks like. And the fascinating thing here is the scale, while it has dropped down precipitously since coming back, it only went up 0.2 pounds following that 4,700 calorie day. So pretty encouraged by that. That's pretty good. So I'm expecting it to kind of hang around the same range for tomorrow and then probably drop going into Tuesday and Wednesday. So the cap's 209. So that conversation about trying to make weight, that's done and gone. A lot of this was to kind of see like, hey, when we have a really big high carb day, how much of a scale bump do we see? Like, are we going to have issues if we drop down below and then we pump up 5 pounds due to carbs? Are we going to have issues making weight? And the answer here clearly is no. So that's encouraging. So I feel really good about this. Again, I'm not thrilled about the holes in the data here just because I'm a little OCD. I would like this all to look a little bit more perfect, but I can accept that we're still in a good place overall. What's up, gang? Real quick here. Hypertrophy University is scheduled for an official release on June 1st, but a lot of lessons are already online right now. So you can head over to 5stardigital.com, check it out. You can pre-order and get started immediately if you are interested in learning everything that you've ever wanted to know about how to lift as effectively and as efficiently as possible. This is the course for you. Check it out. Random shit I hear. This will be brief. It's every single day somebody saying something. I can't go anywhere in the gym without somebody saying something, which is cool. And so this section should probably just go away because I can't catalog what it is. Like, I was in the posing room today. Some dude came in there, and I say posing room, it's a group fitness room. It's just there didn't happen to be a class in there. Some guy came in there, he just wanted to talk to me. So it's like, I'm in there, it's a big giant room, the lights are mostly off, it's quiet in there, and he still comes in and talks to me. So I'm like, all right, cool, I'm fine with it. It's totally cool. It's a good chance, it's a good opportunity to force me to kind of be a little bit less of a hermit. It doesn't give me the opportunity to be as much of an introvert as I might like, which is good for me. I need that experience. So that being said, I look forward to being less lean so that I can have fewer people talking to me. It sounds awful to say that, but there you go. Next step. So here's the thing. So for this week, I need to do something big, something really, really big. And it's not necessarily going to be a programmatic change. There's a little bit of one, but there's a big change that's going to happen under the hood of my head that is far more important. And this is the one thing that's going to help me be successful from now at 4 weeks out up until show day. It's absolutely critical that this happens, and it's something that I haven't tried before, so we're going to see how it goes. And the idea here is what I need to do is have a mental reset where I think, and I fool myself into thinking, that prep starts now. And so a lot of that is just like lying to yourself and believing it. Like, nope, forget the last 18 weeks. That hasn't happened. This is when prep starts. Because right now I'm kind of feeling like there's this momentum thing going on where I'm just kind of like falling downhill a little bit rather than keeping myself upright and putting one foot in front of the other. I'm just kind of relying on this, you know, not super productive momentum to just kind of keep me rolling down the hill. But it needs to be more intentional than that and a little bit more focused. So part of it is just mentally like, hey, last 18 weeks, forget it. And this is just like, you know, clarity of thought and get your head into a space where, you know, find your Zen space in there and just take a deep breath and approach each day as though it's something new. I am going to programmatically do something here and increase my carbs a little bit for the next handful of days. There is going to be a cheat meal that comes in sometime, just a single meal, not a high day like yesterday where it was a blowout. It wasn't a blowout, but it was intentional high carbs all day long. But there is going to be a cheat meal at night. I'm going to meet with Bino the following morning. We're going to do posing sometime this week. I need to figure out when that's going to be. Don't know yet. Other than that, we keep the diet super tight, just with slightly increased carbs. And I'm thinking like an extra 30 grams of carbs, nothing crazy or anything like that, but just kind of signify like, okay, cool. It's a fresh start. Let's get that number back up. See what happens here. And then just treat it like it's the beginning of prep. Oh, that's too high. Cool. Let's bring it back down. And so we're just kind of going to do a little bit of a reset here. That should be all that we really need to do realistically. So I am gonna maybe back off on cardio a little bit. I've been doing 40 minutes post-workout. I'm gonna drop that down to 30 this week and see how that goes. So again, that kind of helps facilitate this mental reset. 40 minutes versus 30, it's a big change. It's only 10 minutes, but you gotta slog through that extra 10. That's hard to do. And so at this point, like I'm so tired, it's like, okay, let's just back it off. A few more carbs, a little less cardio. Let's reset like that for a week and then continue the push if we need to, or if we don't, hey, you know what? We're resetting. It's just like prep has started. And the answer is like, we don't just push harder because we're closer. We push harder if we have to, and that's it. So that's gonna be the approach for this week. Q&A this week. We got nothing. So keep those questions coming, please. I'm getting some comments on these, but there aren't any questions involved, so I'm just going to skip it. So let's move on to a new section that will only happen once. Okay, here we go. We are going to register for this show. We're going to do it together here. So the first thing is we need to update the membership card. So we're going to do that here. We're going to renew the NPC membership. And I think, man, it's ridiculous that it's $150 now. It's crazy. So yeah, okay, we'll renew it. All right, to compete in 2024, you must have a 2024 membership. Yes, yes, I know. Cost is $150, will expire end of year. So this is not good for 1 year from the date of purchase. This is good for a calendar year. That's the one thing to keep in mind about the NPC card specifically. So yes, registration, pay, I don't know, payment info. Are they gonna tell me how I'm paying for this? I don't know, let's just do it, I guess. And now it takes me to, okay, all right, plug in your shit. All right, cool. All right, and pay. All right, let's keep tabs on this. This is $150 for the NPC card here. Okay, we're good, awesome, great. Good luck competing this year. Thank you, appreciate that. So now we go back to registration for the show. It has all my information saved here. Date of birth, March 2nd, 1774. All right, yep, that's me, good. NPC member number, I don't know, did I save that? 701750. Knoxville, Tennessee, select t-shirt size, 2XL, Instagram. Do I have to do this, really? Can't spell my own name right. I'm at that point in prep where I can't spell my name correctly. Division, this is gonna be men's classic physique. So this is the big question that I always get asked by clients, like what category should I compete in? And it really depends on your experience level. Like I know what I wanna do. So the options are true novice. If it's your first time competing, you can compete in true novice. Then there's novice, A, B, and C. You can compete in novice until you win your novice class. Junior, a little too old for that. Masters, 40 plus would be an option. Heroes, that's not me. I'm far from a hero. And then you've got class A, class B, C, and D, depending on height. So we're going to start with masters, 40 plus. We're going to add a class. And then we are going to do classic physique. And then we are going to do masters class C, over 5'10 and up to 5'11, up to and including 209 pounds. Two classes here, it is 105 apiece plus a service fee, so 217.35 by proceeding with payment, blah, 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 blah. So, I love this digital signature. Like, how useless is this? Is just this the dumbest garbage? Like, look at this signature. Like, yes, we accept this signature written by a three-year-old. Why not? Okay, cool. Pay online now. Welcome, blah, blah, blah. Is this PayPal? Yes, they're going to pay through PayPal. Great. All right. I don't really want to pay with PayPal. I would rather use my credit card and get some miles for this. All right. It's done. We are officially registered. But wait, we're not done. So now we're up to $367. Tanning, hair, and makeup. Okay, cool. So liquid sun rays. All right, book here. When do I want to do it? So here you've got your spaces available. Oh man, maybe should have done this a little sooner. So now I'm going to have to get to Chattanooga earlier than I wanted to in order to do this. This is a pain in the ass. So it would have made a lot of sense to do this part before registering for the show, maybe. I always tell people, like, wait until you register for the show until, like, you know, give yourself a chance to break a leg, to get in a car accident, to have a brain tumor, something like, you know, shit can happen when you're in prep. Don't register for a show when you're 20 weeks out. It's just dumb. 4 weeks? Yeah, absolutely. If you wait that long for your tanning, you're gonna end up with something like this now where I'm gonna have to get to Chattanooga a little bit earlier than I wanted to. It's fine. So we'll do 3:30 to 3:45. I'm fine with that. Name, information, blah, 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 classic physique, social media, who cares, add to cart. $145. So this turned into a $500 affair. Plus, I'm going to have to get a hotel room. I'll set up a GoFundMe here. I'm kidding. Don't do that. Don't email me. Don't text me. Don't do any of this crap. Yes, take my credit card, please. And there we go. All right. So just like that, we spent $500 together. It was a nice little shopping spree, wasn't it? Spent $500 and have nothing tangible to show for it. That's a little disappointing, actually. There we are. We are officially registered for the show. We are registered to tan. We've got the NPC card all set up. We're good to go. The last thing that I need to do, which I will not make you wait for me, is figure out where I'm staying. So I will do a little bit of research to figure out, like, I don't know Chattanooga really at all. I know this is at the convention center. I don't know what's around the convention center. We're done there. So now what I'm going to do is show you the posing from this morning, and I'm going to go ahead and narrate a little bit of that offline. By all means, if you have any questions, any comments, leave them down below. Let me know what's on your mind, and I will catch you back here next week. Okay, little extra posing work here. This is following the high day on Saturday the 11th. This is the morning of Sunday the 12th. So a little more filled out. We're going to show a few different camera angles here as we progress through this, just going through the quarter turns here. A couple of these poses, I do remember as I was hitting them, I hit them a little lazy. I was a little too worried about, like, are my cameras set up? Are they turned on, etc.? Like, you can see my tricep isn't really engaged in that shot here. Come around to the back, remembering what Bino told me here, flare the toes out a little bit more to get the hamstrings a little bit more engaged, show a little bit better sweep to the legs. Back needs to be a little bit leaner here. That's what I'm seeing. The legs actually look reasonably lean. It's really the back that's getting me. And I can see also as I go through a lot of these poses here, I really need to get that midsection tightened up. Now, also, I went a little overboard on that high day, so the midsection is still a little distended, just a little bit of like bubbly guts from that. So I need to watch the food selection. I was not particularly careful with food selection on Saturday. Certainly, peak week going into show day, I'll be a lot more careful, using a little less processed stuff and pretty much just all clean, single ingredient foods. This pose, I just got to remember to keep those legs engaged. You can see that kind of flip in and out from being there and not there. Midsection just needs to be way tighter. So I need to really put a priority here as I look at this on vacuum. And I need to be wearing my waist trainer every time I'm doing cardio. That's not a substitute for doing vacuums, but I need to do both at this stage. That's really the main thing that needs to happen, is I need to be able to pull that waist in tighter. Actually, pretty happy with how the legs look here, to be honest with you. Not mad about that at all. One of these side poses here, you can really see where the waist, yeah, just needs to come in. It's just like really not impressive. That just does not look good. That's a really blocky midsection there. Any judging feedback that I get, I already know what it's going to be. Bring your legs up, bring your midsection in. And honestly, like, the off season is where that happens. So it looks okay there. Like, from the back, it looks fine. It's just like from the side poses, from the front poses also, like, I'd like to bring the lats up a little bit more, just because that's going to make the waist look a little bit smaller. But just keeping it tighter, off season vacuums, etc., is going to have to be a much bigger priority here. This pose in particular, I think, is one where it's like, yeah, not really happy with that. The serratus are coming in okay. I'm good with that. It's just that waist needs to be a lot tighter. I don't know how much of that I can really change in 4 weeks, but that's got to be a priority here. Trying my hand at some classic physique poses. I haven't tried these in a while. Shaking off a little bit of rust on those. This side chest zombie style pose here. I kind of dig this. I don't know that I really pull it off very well, but I like it. Kind of like the way it accents the legs too. So that was one round. I did 3 rounds of posing on this day, but that's the first one. Not too bad overall. Just some things to work on.